Hello friends, myself Rakesh Roshan from Learn Tech to Tech channel, and in this video we will do the discussion on the storage devices. But before that, I just request you to please subscribe my channel Learn Tech to Tech, and do not forget to click on the bell so that you will get notification of every my new video. So let us start with the storage device. You know that storage devices are the very important component of the computer system, because before processing and after processing we require the storage devices. So here you see that the storage device is any hardware device that is used for storing your data, then porting your data and extracting your data, files and objects. That means your data may be the simple text file or image or something motion pictures. It can hold and store information both temporarily and permanently. That means the storage devices will store the data permanently as well as temporarily, and can be internal or external to a computer. That means there may be some storage device within the computer, and there may be some storage device external to the computer. That means you can remove the external device from the computer or any server or any computing devices. Storage devices are used to store the data before and after a process by the computer. Different storage devices have different size and capacity. So there are lots of storage devices are there in the market, and each storage devices have the different size and the different capacity, as well as the cost of the storage devices are also different. Now we see the first storage devices, that is the magnetic storage device. Here we see the categories of the storage devices. Here we are discussing the categories of the storage devices. So first of all, it is the magnetic storage devices. Actually, magnetic storage device is one of the most affordable way to store large amount of data. That means it is very cheap and it is low cost, and it is a very low cost storage devices. Some of the magnetic storage devices are magnetic tape, magnetic disk, floppy disk and hard disk drive. Some of the magnetic storage devices are outdated. So this, for example, floppy disk, nowadays floppy disk is not available in the market, and magnetic tapes are also not available in the market. In the current scenario, we are using the hard disk drive. Magnetic tape data storage is a system for storing digital information on the magnetic tape using digital recording. That means in the early time, the magnetic tape are used for the storing digital information by the digital recording. Similarly, the magnetic storage or magnetic recording is the storage of data on a magnetized medium. That means always magnetic storage will be possible only in the magnetized medium. The medium which is magnetized, in that medium only we can store the data. Second is optical storage device. If you see the optical storage device, actually optical storage is any storage method in which data is written and read with a ledger for archival or backup purpose. That means whether we are reading or writing the data from the storage devices, that will be through the rail ledger. So that type of device, storage devices, are called optical device. For example, data is written to the optical media such as CDs or DVDs. So CDs, that is compact disc, and the DVDs are the example of optical storage devices. And you know that the capacity of CDs are less in comparison to DVDs, and CDs capacities are approximately 700 MB, but DVDs capacities are 4.5 GB or more than 4 GB. Optical media is more reliable and durable than tape. That means magnetic tape is not very durable, but here optical media, that is the more reliable than the more reliable as well as durable than the tape. Then last one is flash memory. Actually, flash memory is the very fast memory. Through the flash memory, you can access anything very fastly. So nowadays, flash memory is very popular, and you can see that you can see that in most of the costly laptops or notebooks, they use the flash memory. Flash memory of a form of semiconductor memory. It is actually the semiconductor memory, and it is widely used for many electronics data storage applications. That means for all the electronics data storage application, the flash memory is one of the important memory devices. Flash memory storage is a form of non-volatile memory, so it is the non-volatile memory, and that was born out of a combination of traditional EEPROM and EEPROM. That means the bone of the flash memory came by the combination of the traditional EEPROM, or you can say that the type of ROM, that is electronically programmable read-only memory and electronically erasable programmed read-only memory and electronically erasable programmed read-only memory. So by combining these two traditional memory, the flash memory is evaluated. Firstly developed in 1980s, that means flash memory is very old technology, but the use of flash memory grows rapidly in modern days. So in the modern days there are lots of uses of the flash memory in the computer system. So these are the small introduction of the storage devices. So I hope that you understand all the things very well, and so like my video and share my video with your friends and colleagues, and please do not forget to subscribe my channel Learn Tech to Tech. Thank you and goodbye.